Hey, this is Julian and you are on EatTheBlocks, and in this video I'm going to explain you the concept of a gas. So when you're a beginner and you want to learn how to build a decentralized application on Ethereum, very quick you stumble upon this weird concept of gas. So what it is? Well, very simply, gas is a transaction fee. So every time you send a transaction to the Ethereum blockchain, you have to pay this gas fee. So one thing is very important to understand. You only need to pay gas when you want to modify data on the blockchain. If you just want to read the data, you don't need to spend any gas. So in Solidity, all the function with the view or pure keyword, they are read only. So for this function, you don't need to spend anything. So second question, who pays gas? The payer of gas is the sender of the transaction. So if I sign a transaction, that means that I will be the payer of gas. Next, who receive gas? Miners receive gas. So miners are people or entities that add data to the blockchain, and to reward them of their work, then we pay them this gas. When gas is paid? Gas is paid when it is mined by a miner. So that means if I send a transaction at a certain time and I send it to the Ethereum blockchain, I'm not going to pay any gas until a miner includes it in the blockchain. Actually, it's possible that no miner want to include my transaction, and in this case, I will never pay anything. So it's a little bit like a check that you sign. Where to buy some gas? After all, if you have to pay it, maybe that you need to first acquire it, right? Well, actually no, because gas is just a measurement. This is an abstract unit. So the transaction cost is measured in gas, but you actually pay it in Ether. And I'm gonna explain you in the next videos exactly how you can go from gas to Ether. How to pay gas? Well, the only thing you need to do is to sign your transaction, you send it to the Ethereum network, and then the Ethereum protocol directly is going to debit some Ether from your Ethereum address, but you don't have to do anything. By the way, if you don't have enough Ether in your address, then you won't be able to pay this gas cost and your transaction will fail.
By the way, if you want to know my most useful Solidity tips, check this free email series, link in the description.
In the next video of this series, we'll go much more in details about what is gas and when you're a developer, what you have to know about it and how you can set the gas parameters for your transaction. So we'll stop here, and in the next video, I'll talk about why we came up with this concept of gas and how comes we just don't do the transaction cost in Ether, for example. That would be more simple, right? I'm gonna explain you all of this. Thanks for watching, guys. See you for the next video.